That's all he would say, and I didn't know what the heck he meant. A little frustrating. Ruben, you're only 6 inches away from massive success. And he'd smile and kind of walk away. Well, I wasn't sure what he meant. Finally, after asking him, he would say, 6 inches is the distance between your ears. Your success depends on what you feed your mind. Well, he was talking about the inner game. He was talking about programming your mind for success. I mean, but it would be years before I really understood what he meant. Today, I realize he was 100% right. Even if he had explained it back then, which he didn't, but even if he had explained it, I wasn't ready to take that information in. I wasn't ready to buy it. I wasn't ready to believe it. And so it would have been wasted on me. It's just like when the student is ready, the teacher will appear. Well, you have to be ready. And that's why you want to read the best books. You read them over and over and over and over again. Think and Grow Rich, How to Win Friends and Influence People, The Magic of Thinking Big, books like that. You want to read them over and over and over again, because I guarantee you 5 years from now, you'll be a different person than you are today. And you will be picking up insights from those books. Even if you've read them 20 times, in 5 years, you'll be picking up insights that will make sense to you for the first time. And when he told me, 6 inches is the distance between your ears, your success depends on what you feed your mind, that made no sense. Today, it makes 100% sense. And so you always hear about that, the mental part of sports being more important than the physical part. And I have to admit that I was always skeptical. I really was. That is, until a cold morning in October 1998. I took up the sport of luge in 1984, right after the Sarajevo Olympics, right after seeing Scott Hamilton win the gold medal. And then I retired right after the 1992 Albertville Olympics. So I competed in the 88 games in Calgary and the 92 games in Albertville, and then I retired. After Albertville, I didn't take a luge run for 6 years. I was done. I'd retired from the sport. However, during those 6 years, I read hundreds of books on success and listened to thousands of motivational tapes and went to tons of seminars and hardly ever watched TV, stayed away from newspapers, stayed away from negative input. 7 out of 10 stories in the newspaper and 7 out of 10 stories in your newscast at night are negative. If you don't believe me, take a pad of paper, watch the news, and start tallying them. And I guarantee you, probably more than 7 are negative. So do you need all that negative? Absolutely not. And for those 6 years, I just immersed my brain in positive. Read good books, listened to good tapes, hang around great people, and stayed away from negative stuff. Unbeknownst to me, by doing that, I was gradually becoming mentally tougher, tougher and tougher and tougher. Well, in 1998, 6 years after retiring from the luge, I decided to begin training for the 2002 Salt Lake City Olympics. My first day of training was unforgettable, unbelievable. I was at the start of the Calgary luge track, ready to take my first run in 6 years. Surprisingly, I was feeling cool, calm, and confident. Believe it or not, my first 4 runs were personal bests, perfect clean runs and personal best times after a 6 years hiatus. It was even better than getting back on a bike. I felt more in control of that sled than ever before. 4 personal bests after a 6-year break. Unbelievable. That day, I stopped being a skeptic. That's the day I became a believer in the power of the human mind. High achievers in every field share certain beliefs that give them a competitive edge. Beliefs that are designed to keep them hungry, confident, and mentally tough so they will do what it takes to win. Beliefs that anyone can adopt to have better results in their personal and professional life. And so if you adopt the following beliefs, you are guaranteed to win much more often. Number 1, failure does not exist. Okay? Failure does not exist. Just believe it. Just force yourself to believe it. Just because I crashed the last 5 times on a loose track doesn't mean I'm going to crash next time. See, the past does not determine the future. Every time I come down that track, I'm a better racer because I'm more experienced than on the previous run. That is, if I learn something from my mistakes and then I apply the knowledge on the next run, right? No different from this tape set, guys. No different from reading a good book. It's not just the reading it. You have to apply it, right? But when Thomas Edison was trying to find the right filament to make the light bulb work, a reporter asked him how it felt to have failed thousands of times. And Edison laughed. He said he hadn't failed. He said he had just discovered thousands of materials that didn't work. Edison wasn't being a smart aleck. He was just protecting his positive attitude by refusing to believe that he had failed. You see, high achievers believe that they are destined to accomplish great things in their lifetimes. They've just gotten to the point where they just believe that it's just a matter of time. They believe that the challenges they experience are there to teach them a lesson they need to learn in order to complete their mission in life. They believe there's no such thing as failure. They either get the desired outcome or else they learn something that will help them win in the future. So no matter what happens, they win. See, the past doesn't equal the future. It just doesn't. By thinking this way, discouragement can't get a foothold in their mind. And so start thinking that way. Start believing that failure does not exist. Number two, big belief of winners. If it is to be, it is up to me. If it is to be, it is up to me. That just means take responsibility. Every single one of the people in the biographies I read had to overcome major challenges on the road to success. Struggling through those challenges is what made them great. A piece of coal has to experience a huge amount of heat and pressure in order to become a diamond. And we're no different. Every time we face a challenge, we have a choice to make. Will we get bitter or will we get better? You better decide to get better. Face a challenge. I mean, it's there to make you stronger. You're going to need that strength further up the road when you'll be facing even bigger challenges. You will. And so take a chance. You never know what you're missing in life until you dare to pursue your dream. So don't make excuses. Whenever you make an excuse, you're giving up control. If you do make an excuse for not pursuing your dream, make sure it's a good one, because you're going to have to live with it for the rest of your life. So don't rationalize. Rationalizing is telling yourself rational lies. Believe that you're in charge of your life. You are totally responsible. You create the results. You are in control of your life. You have the power to change your circumstances. Believe it. And belief is a choice. It's a choice. You just start saying it. I believe, I believe, I believe, I can do it. I'm in charge. I can do it. It's a matter of time. I'll do it. It's a matter of time. It's going to happen. It's my destiny. I was created to make it happen, and it's going to happen. You just start saying that, and you start believing it. Number three, commit. Commit to win, okay? Make a commitment. Some people are interested in reaching their dreams, and others are committed to reaching their dreams. The key to success in life is going from being interested to being committed. See, once you're committed, you will produce results. At the point of commitment, you mentally burn all the bridges, and you start doing whatever it takes to make it happen. That's when you become unstoppable. It's a mental decision. On the road to the Olympics, many athletes, much faster than me, quit along the way. And there's only two reasons they quit. They either didn't want it bad enough, or they weren't as committed. Commitment is what makes success possible. If you commit to do whatever it takes, as long as it's moral, legal, and ethical, to succeed, success will reveal its secrets to you. It will. There are four different levels of commitment. There's I'll try, then there's I'll do my best, then there's I'll do whatever it takes, and finally there's it's a done deal. Now, I'll try is completely worthless. Whenever somebody tells you they're going to try to do something, don't count on anything ever happening. People say, I'll try, when they're afraid to say, I won't. I'll try is the battle cry of wimps. It really is. Whenever you say, I'll try, you've just guaranteed failure. You really have. Because saying, I'll try, is in effect saying, if there are any obstacles, I'll have a way out, and I'll be able to quit. That's what I'll try says. I'll do my best is really not much better than I'll try. It sounds good. Oh, it really sounds good. I'll do my best. Well, it's not that great. People that say I'll do my best are looking for a way out. When they say they'll do their best, they're leaving a huge door open for excuses and justifications later. They are. Remember when you asked your buddies to help you move out of your first apartment? Remember that? I know for sure that none of the ones who said I'll try to be there or I'll do my best to be there showed up. They didn't. Winners don't say that. Winners say, I'll do whatever it takes. Yeah, I'll do whatever it takes. If you tell somebody you'll do whatever it takes, you have to produce, or else you'll lose face. You will. Finally, the strongest level of commitment is when you say, it's a done deal. When you say it's a done deal, even losing face is not an option. When I was training for the Olympics, I wouldn't dare tell my coach I was going to try to do something. It was always, it's a done deal. Yeah. We walked the track with the coach. We made a game plan about the best way to drive the track. We visualized and mentally rehearsed the ideal run. But sooner or later, you know what? We had to commit. Sooner or later, we had to hop on that sled and slide down that mountain. We had to take those runs, knowing that even with all the preparation, the first few times down that track were going to be pretty brutal. Yeah. Was it scary? Sure it was. It was scary. It was really scary. But you got to pay the price if you want to enjoy the prize. You have to. You have to commit to do things that are beyond your current abilities. That's the only way to grow. That's how you get better and stronger. So attack your fears head on. Otherwise, you'll be their servant for the rest of your life. You will. Take a chance. Act on faith. Put yourself in a position where you have to stretch and fight for something. It brings out the best in you. It's good for your soul. It really is.